Alright guys, we're going to do another little video. I'm hoping this turns out pretty good, so we'll see.
Y'all way up there. I call this one the jump of doom. I'll have to get the camera down in a minute to let you guys see. When I jump here, I gotta thread the needle between a tree and my van. And then when you're coming back up, you've got to watch the trees and stuff. It gets kind of crazy. Thank you.
Still good.
Side of them. Xmaxx tough, baby. think that might have been battery cutoff.
I'll take you guys with me. I'm pretty sure you heard it.
I caught the wheel.
Man. See, that's what scares me about jumping that thing sometimes. I'm gonna have to start moving my vehicle. But as you can see, I'm way over there. If you look here, this is where I start jumping, or where I jump from. And I go all the way over there. And you can see the tree to the left and my van, so I try and hit that center spot every time. Oh yeah, when I hit the house, luckily I just hit the cable box. Luckily it's just the cable box. I'll take you on down with me. I don't know if it come loose or if it's power cut off. I think it was power cut off. But that's my piles of dirt that I'm gonna make a track out of. I'm gonna start right back here. And it's gonna come all the way back up through here. This whole little section right here is gonna be nothing but track. And yes, fellas, you're gonna have to jump between the trees. It's not gonna be an easy track. Well, let's open it up and see. I believe it might have just cut off, either that or the battery popped out. Yeah, stupid connectors popped out again. Which means I still got some more runtime. Probably not much, because it's probably about done. I want you to look at this body. I torture this thing, and it's holding up good. When I first got it, it wouldn't do nothing hardly. I mean, everything I tried, it would just look at me and break and laugh. Not no more, I laugh at it now. Oh, see, I hate these controllers because I can't drive one-handed. You can, but it's very hard. The big green Xmaxx machine. Let's see if I can. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do this. It just ain't gonna happen. Yep. I just bag it up. All right, guys. I think I'm gonna end it here. But that's my Xmaxx. I tell you what, while we're out here in the sun, I wanna let you guys see what I've done to mine. Of course, you've seen on the video, I did the RPM arms, and also I did the pins, and I've got the RPM rear hubs on the rear. And then you go to the front, I've done the RPM arms, the Traxxas aluminum stabilizer arms, and I've got a brand new set of bearings gonna go in this thing. And also, I think I can get a good view of it. All of my linkage is aluminum down in there, and I upgraded to the bigger servo as well. Now, to me, myself, I love the linkage. I love everything being aluminum up there. I got a lot less tire flip-flop when I done that. That really made a big difference. But other than that, mainly on the four corners and the steering mechanism, everything else is stock. Fun in the sun. It's getting to be that time of the year. It's time to get them all back out, boys. I don't like running mine in the winter time. And I think you've noticed that with everybody. Every time somebody runs in the snow, they're breaking something. That's why I don't run mine in the snow much, unless I'm just driving on the ground or something like that. This is my Xmaxx. All in its green glory. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Like and subscribe if you did. We'll talk to you next time.